Hello, everyone. I finally sent the design files for my relatively universal ROM programmer shield off to a manufacturer, and it's going to be about a week before I get the finished boards back, but I'm not going to let that stop me from showing off what's coming. I'm having the whole thing assembled, except for the socket and pin headers, so I really, really hope it's going to work the way it is here without any botches. As you might be able to glean from the big thing in the middle, I expect to put a 32-pin SIF socket in there. Note that if the ROM you're programming is smaller than 32 pins, you have to put it with pin 1 towards the handle, but most importantly, seat it all the way to the right. So a 24-pin ROM would be taking up about this area here. And at the bottom, I've put the two buttons found on a 65 Ueno, and of course, like the whole thing itself, it should also work on any other controller that accepts Arduino shields. At the bottom, we also have pins to connect an external UART that we'll use to upload the file to burn a bit later, and I also put a header connection for an OLED display since it wouldn't fit so nicely hanging over the socket. I've put the three registers at the bottom too and put the outputs on an optional pin header, and I've put 24 LEDs on it too. I'm sure that's going to look spectacular. Thinking about it, the board is also going to be pretty useful if you need to drive 24 signals for other things too. If you're new to the channel, but I somehow kept your attention this far anyway, I hope you'll stick around. If I lost you a bit, what we have here is an Arduino-style programming shield to program basically any ROM, and it should end up being a lot cheaper than the usual ROM programmers. It'll end up being less than $10, and even less if you make it yourself. It's fully open, so it's easy to make one. On the right, we have the programming voltage driver transistors, and up top we have a header with the driver outputs, in case you want to use them off-board. That's also where you'll find three red LEDs indicating the socket has hot pins that might fry something. At the top, we have the programming voltage regulator and a trim pot that should let us adjust the voltage between 8 and 22 volts. To calibrate the voltage, you just enable the regulator in software without anything in the socket, of course, and slowly turn the trim pot while watching the voltage on the VPE pin with a multimeter. Hopefully, it won't be too long before I can demo that for real. If you need a higher voltage than that, you might want to replace either the trim pot or R8 next to it. You'll find some hints about doing that on the schematic, which is on GitHub, of course. If you find all this a bit confusing, it'll probably get a bit better if we flip the board around. Or potentially worse, but let's see if we can avoid that. Most of the documenting silkscreen is on the bottom, and you'll see the outline of where to place the different ROM sizes in the socket on the front. I've labeled the control register pins in case you need to use them for other things, and the other two headers are the address line outputs. If we turn the board a bit, we can see how to configure the board for different ROMs. For most ROMs, the 28-pin configuration is fine, but since we're going for universal, I had to make some options available. You can either use them as solder jumpers if you don't plan on changing things too often, or plug in pin headers for jumpers on the other side. For debugging, I have indicated on the socket outline where the different signals go, but to configure it, you just have to know you need to put a solder blob here for 24-pin ROMs, here and here for 28-pin ROMs, and here for 32-pin ROMs. JP3 you only need to use if the ROM you're programming needs VPP on pin 1. So a 28-pin ROM with VPP on pin 1 would need a blob here, and a 32-pin ROM which needs VPP on pin 1, a blob here. As a bonus, I also had room for another header which has the I2C lines, 3 volts and ground, along with the pins called A0 and A1 on an Arduino. And the rest is just software. I'll make some basic examples in Arduino C and maybe a library, and if you watched my other videos, you already know we have the breadboard version working with a 6502 computer. When I get the board, I'll make it available on my webshop, and I'm pretty confident we can keep the price point under $10. certainly without the SIF socket. If you like this kind of stuff, I'm sure you'll also appreciate my 65 Arduino that I gave away a bunch of a few months ago. So go check that out. Either way, thanks for watching.